All right, we're on Erchin Perek Tet, Mishnah Gimel, third Mishnah, in the ninth chapter of Masechet Erchin. Okay, we're going to now turn to Batei Arei Chomas. Until now, we've learned about selling Sde Achuza. I made a little chart. Okay, so in this chart, we learned about Sde Achuza, and we're talking about during the time of Yovel. Okay, when can you redeem it? Matai go alim? When are you allowed to redeem it if you sold it? 2 years after. What happens in Yovel? Goes back to original owners. Okay, when you buy it back, do you have to refund? Yes. You have to refund the years, extra years, and then you refund them to the purchaser. Okay? On the other end, we're gonna learn something called Batei Arei Chomas. Let's go back to Vayikra La Cafe, Vayikra 25. It says the Torah. The ish ki imkor beit moshav ir choma. Prince was that sells a house, a dwelling house in a walled city. It has to be a walled city from the time of Yehoshua ben Nun. We're going to see there was a bunch of those. Vaita gulato ad shno atom shnat mimkaro. He can redeem it until the end of the year of its sale. Yamim tiyeh gulato, for a full year, meaning days by count of days. Ve'im lo yigael ad lo shlo shanat mima. And but if he doesn't redeem the house, meaning when you sell a house, you have a year to buy it back. But if you don't, then become a bait asher ba'ir, asher lo choma, right? Then that house that's in the city that's lo, it's written lo with an aleph, but read as lo choma, that has a wall, that's mitut. Permanently la koneo tole dorotav, it becomes a permanent possession of the buyer, lo yetze ba'yovel. Okay? Then it doesn't go out during the time of Yovel. So that's, we learned about Sadeh Achuza. Now we're going to learn about Beit Ir Batech Arei Choma, and then we're also going to learn about a third thing called Batech Hatzavim. We'll get to that later. But our Mishnah, the next couple of Mishnayot are Batech Arei Choma. Says the Mishnah, Hamocher Bayin Batech Arei Choma. If you sell your house in Batech Arei Choma, Harei Zegu Eli, I do have immediately. You can redeem it right away. The Goel Kol Shnei Masachad. You have 12 months. Okay. Harei Zegu Kimin Ribit Ve'Einar Ribit. And it's like ribit, it's like interest, but it's not interest. Meaning, harei zeh kimin ribit. Kishemachzir lo me'otav b'toch shana. When the guy, let's say I sell a house, okay? I made not only a chart, I made a picture because I see these things much better when I see them visually. Let's get these words out of here. Okay, so I got this picture. I'm Reuven. I'm buying the house from Shimon. So I give Shimon my $100,000. And I take the house, and the house comes to me. So I don't, like, I can either live in the house. Let's say I rent out the house for 1,000 shekel a month. 100,000 shekel, 1,000 shekel a month. Okay? Now Shimon has 12 months in order to buy back the house. Shimon comes back and says, yeah, wait, here's your $100,000. I want to take back the house. So the halacha is that he doesn't deduct. So I use the house for 10 months. I benefited 1,000 shekel a month. I benefited 10,000 shekel. So in essence, I got a plus of 10,000 shekel, plus I got the full loan back. So let's say, think about it in a second. Let's say the house was not part of the, let's say I said to Shimon, hey Shimon, said to me, can I borrow $100,000? And I say, sure. And he says, by the way, I'll pay you 1,000 shekel a month for every month that I have $100,000. That is called ribit. But here, it's not in the concept of ribit, it's in the concept of a sale. Okay? I took the house, and he took the money. It was a sale. Now, when he was redeemed it, he does not pay me back 1,000 shekel a month. And that's what the Mishnah says. The Mishnah says, Harei zeh kimin ribit, it's like ribit, but veina ribit, but it isn't ribit. It's not like kimin ribit, meaning, okay, when he returns the money, the enzim and akel lo klum, he doesn't deduct anything. Nimsa, it turns out, shenishtamesh bebeito bischar hamtanat ma'otav. He is using the house, bischar, for the money, for the reward of, or for the price of hamtanat ma'otav, his money, meaning like I get the money because my money is parked at Shimon's. That's essentially a loan, but it's not ribit. Why? In a ribit d'murah, it's not called ribit. Some say it's not ribit because the Torah says you're allowed to do it. It's done in the process of a sale, not in the process of a loan. Meita mocher. Let's say the seller dies, his son has the right to redeem the house, to buy back the house for that year. If the buyer dies, then the seller can go to him, to the inheritor, and say he has the same 12 months. Okay, you only You don't count the year except for Mishah Shemachala, from the time that it was sold, i.e. the initial sale. Says the Bartanura, Sheim Echara Ruben the Shimon ben Nisan. Shimon the Levi be Iyar. Ruben originally sells it in Nisan, and Shimon sells it to Levi in Iyar. Shimon has to worry and just be until Nisan. Meaning it's only the first sale, the original sale. Okay, Shneemar says, I'm the old no shall not to be mine until he finishes, until he completes a whole year. And when it said the word Timima, whole pure, Lahavi Chodesh Ibu, that includes Chodesh Ibu, the pregnant month, i.e., if there's an extra month of Adar, then the guy gets an extra month. Lucky him, he has an extra month in order to buy back the field. Meaning it's like beginning of Nisan, the beginning of the field Nisan the next year. It's not 12 months. Rabbi Omer, Rabbi says, Yitain lo shana v'ibu. Rabbi says, no, it's not 12, it's not 13 months. It doesn't get full 13 months. Rather, whether it's a shanat ibu or not, okay, it doesn't go by the shanat, the lunar month of 13 lunar months. Rather, okay, Yamim Shiyatim Shnat Chama al Shnat Lebana Acharas Yom. Rather, it's a solar month. So he gets 11 extra days. The solar month is 365 days. The lunar month is 354 days. So therefore, you count 365 days. It's the same English day a year later, not the same Hebrew day. That's what it means. Shana Hebrew Ra. But the Bartanura says Halacha Zay Chachamim. So we'll know when the Tefach Yoma. We'll stop here. Dedicate on the memory of my father, Rav Simcha Ben Yitzchak Kalman. Remind you to register, to sign up, to subscribe on our Telegram channel, and you'll get an update every single day. Have a great day.